for IT services and mobile industries. He's also a managing partner for Outsource Brazil, an international business development advisory focused in providing tailored intelligence and objective execution. He has a great understanding of how the cultural differences between two countries can actually have an impact but can be taken advantage of. I'd like to now invite Mr. Robert Janssen to make his presentation.
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up to government. more transparency, to be more citizenship. Focus on the core issues where, you know, this is where we see government should be focusing in, and where they are able to provide greater healthcare, they're able to provide greater education, they're able to protect our environment, and they are transparent in providing their services to their citizens. Promote greater socioeconomic inclusion. And when we share this idea, this is what I want to share first with you. We often come here competition, and then we hear co-opetition among competitors. Who hasn't heard co-opetition before? See, everyone has known what co-opetition means. But co-opetition among countries, competition among companies, is not sufficient for the challenge that lies ahead of us. Co-opetition is very good because what you're doing is collaborating on a specific project. After that project is done, each one goes their own way and off you go. Competition, what you want to share with you, is actually sharing a vision. It's collaborating at the strategy level of developing future geography, developing new economic growth, and at the same time being able to provide the socioeconomic inclusion that we all need. Michael Porter mentioned our services today is one of the most endeavors of job creation. And yet we face greater challenges. Who has opened the Times of India today will see at the front page, you know, even though India is at the forefront of the IT industry, there is about 400 million 15 years of age, which cannot, half of it does not complete the eighth grade. There is a lot of challenges among the developing countries, and we have to take seize the opportunity that we have here, and through politicians sharing a vision, sharing a strategy, to be able to promote this economic and social inclusion. So when we're looking at politicians, we're looking exactly, looking at the future market growth, where we're able to provide not only the industry domain knowledge, but also the social, economic, inclusive collaboration. Dr. Ganesh Tarajan, his opening statement yesterday, he said that magic word, you know, to collaborate. And this is what we need to do, and all of us, you know, in our own endeavors, in our own challenges, even a single person. I have a big commitment to myself, even though I might be the size of a grain of the sand on Ipanema Beach, only a small grain of sand, I still want to be a grain of sand that shines, that can be able to collaborate. There is a movement called the Global Sourcing Council that just recently put out a message that we all should be sustainable and socially responsible. And they were giving an award to the best projects out there. And an institution out of India called Heads Held High, with a project called Village BPO, won the award. And what they have done, at a very small size, they took a little small village and were able to promote socioeconomic inclusion, taking people out of misery, out of poverty, and give them dignity, and give them a potential possibility of being a part of a society. So the main focus of communication is, besides all the business-related issues that we know, yes, at the end of the day, organizations in the economic world have to make a profit, but we want you to make a socially and sustainable social profit. So increase overall quality of life of the citizens, and always promote socioeconomic inclusion. And there are many ways we can do that. Currently, right now, there are ways in which governments can incentivize organizations to be more sustainable and socially responsible. Who has heard of ISO 26000? Raise your hand. One person. So now we'll have about 120 that walk out this room and understand that right now the ISO standard is creating something specifically to give you a guideline and how to be socially responsible and how to be sustainable. Because at the end of the day, yes, our private organizations can foster and grow and have a profit. But if we haven't met the challenge of bringing everyone from our developing world and for everyone from our country to be able also to be included, we have not actually met our endeavor. We have not done our job. So, from Brazil, we want to share that, you know, the future is collaborative. I used to say in many of the visions before that before the internet, we were only sure of two things in our lives. We're going to die one day, Brazil is a great collaborative country. People don't realize that Brazil did a study conducted by the Business Review Institute in 2006. They went out to study the mixes of the races, and the conclusion they come to paint them is that the Brazilian race is the most mixed race on the planet. Anyone in this room can hold a Brazilian passport. Anyone. The largest Japanese community outside Japan is in Brazil. The largest Italian community outside Italy is in Brazil.
The largest German community outside Germany
is also in Brazil. Brazil also has the second largest African heritage worldwide. And the one that does it today is there's no cultural barriers. We hit the ground running. We're very open. We're always welcome. The future about sharing a business platform is, well, Brazil can come up with a great industrial business domain. There's over 50 economic sectors in Brazil that are very strong. People realize, Brazil, yeah, soccer, carnival. Well, guess what? A lot of the small region aircraft that you fly here, you fly in the US, you fly here, are made in Brazil by aircraft. A lot of the agriculture machinery that you're using out in your agriculture fields is also made by massive workers in Brazil. And it goes on. So the future is being about constant change in Brazil because of all its past and, you know, high inflation and different economic governments, different types of form of government. We've seen it all. So we are kind of a PhD in change management. And the Brazilian government is very socially active. You've heard of our last president, Lula. He's been in office for 8 years. He just stepped down. But he's created one of the most prolific social and economic inclusion programs called Bolsa Família, the family purse. For every school that a parent maintains, for every child that a parent maintains in school, they get a purse. They get $100. So we have made some successful programs that we can also share with everyone. And at the end of the day, we want you just to be a partner with social and economic inclusion, challenge, and impact. If you want to hear more about Brazil, we're available outside. There's a blog here which you can also have all kinds of information on what Brazil IT represents. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You know, Brazil reminds me of my first visit.